welcome our final speaker before we do closing remarks with Q&A. State delegate candidate for the Green Party for District 7, which encompasses Baltimore County and Harford County, Brian Kelvin.
Hello, and I just want to thank Tamara for, you know, just, I think really this, the way suburban communities are pitted against the city communities and vice versa, that's an element of this whole struggle that really just cannot be ignored. Baltimore region has for far too long suffered from intentionally dysfunctional approaches to transit. Baltimore region drive times are slower today than they were 40 years ago. To add insult to injury, Governor Hogan's canceling of the Red Line project upon taking office represented an acceleration of historical injustices and misrepresentation impacting and intensifying the region's social stratification, negative economic progress, and the overall transit detention we're all subject to living here. I'm running for one of the delegate seats currently occupied by Kathy Shalega, Pat McDonough, and Rick Impolaria in the 7th Legislative District just north of Baltimore city limits. Whenever a new bus line, metro project, or any legislation related to improving public transit in Northeast Baltimore County or Harford County comes along, these xenophobic, racist, and classist, and otherwise regressive legislators are always the most vociferous opposition Maryland State House has to offer on those projects. At this point, public transit need is so desperate in these areas that these reactionary legislators are speaking to. Just having basic bus lines that operate at regular east to west routes throughout the Baltimore County community would greatly increase public mobility for all our area's residents. Efficient public transit is urban and suburban centers as well lends itself to systemically transitioning the region away from car-centric transportation models that are inefficient and that are killing our ecosystems. However, as dysfunctional as our highly irregular to inaccessible Baltimore County north-south bus lines are, the Harford County parts of District 7 that I hope to represent are virtually inaccessible to surrounding regions via any public transit option at all. As a food service worker in Baltimore County for the better part of a decade, I have worked, and I do continue to work, with people in Baltimore County who are entirely dependent on public transit. Too often, my coworkers there, relying on bus transit lines as their primary means of transportation, have been fired because of the frequent lateness, dysfunction, in area transit generates. Enough is enough. Our collective path forward on transit justice cannot ignore either the historical injustices or material realities inside the Baltimore City area or their interconnectivity with surrounding communities. Getting concessions from Maryland's ruling class and political elites requires community organizing and major pushbacks against representatives claiming area residents don't need increased access to public transit lines. As someone who has lived in the area all my life, I can tell you with 100% certainty that this is not true. The limited to non-existent public transit in Perry Hall, where I live and grew up, has undeniably impacted my access to the surrounding region and my range of opportunities in general. The organizing and social solidarity that have time and again historically been able to achieve concrete commitments on transit initiatives from candidates and representatives in exchange for delivering critical voting blocks is a partial model for success. We need vocal commitment to correcting these errors in public transit from any candidate or organization in a position to influence movement or policy on Baltimore and Maryland transit justice. If someone is seeking your vote or support, make sure they've taken an affirmative position on this vitally important issue. However, we all must also get on those buses, trains, metros, and as well go into our suburban communities that ideal transit could reach. We've got to talk to and organize with those most affected, because it's through them that progress is possible. We must never forget that we, the people, are the only real agents of change in any era. Thank you.